Okay, so we're at Lake Trillium and we're actually on top of a lake.
Hey everyone, it's the Hungry Tourist, and today we're walking across a frozen lake.
Right behind me is beautiful Mount Hood. The sun is out. There's lots of people camping out, having snacks. I think there might be some people trying to ice fish. Not sure.
I thought it would be the perfect day to get in our car and drive to Mount Hood. You can see Mount Hood from both Washington and Oregon. We decided we wanted to view the mountain from Lake Trillium. Only issue, Lake Trillium's frozen over! Not a problem for us though, we went anyway. The lake is located on Mount Hood's southwest side in Oregon. It is situated at an elevation of approximately 3,600 feet. To get to the frozen lake, you must do a little hiking first. There is parking near the trailhead and no cost to get into Mount Hood National Forest. We are having a great time. It is not too cold out here. We are just hiking, enjoying the snow. It really snowed a lot 3 days ago, and so it finally let down a little bit. So we decided, hey, it would be a great time to drive to Mount Hood and see what all the action is. Lots of people today went a couple months ago, and it was too cold, so we decided to go later in the year. The trail is approximately 2.6 miles long and takes hikers around the perimeter of Lake Trillium. It's a moderate level hike with some elevation gain and few steep sections. Okay, check out this little hidey hole I found. Just the most gorgeous place ever. We had a really great time on the trail. It's absolutely beautiful, and we met some really cool people along the way. I mean, look at that perfectly fluffy snow behind me. It's just so easy to walk in and so white, sparkling. I just feel energized, re-energized being out here. After a short, moderate hike, we were able to reach Lake Trillium. The entire lake was covered in snow, so I wasn't exactly sure what parts were solid and what areas I could probably step through. So we have people fishing
on this frozen lake. In the springtime, it's just complete water swimming. Right now, it's solid and there's people playing games. We're just all hanging out. It's pretty cool. We quickly found out that you needed to be very aware of where you were stepping.
Look at what you got.
Yum. We are very prepared for this trip. Extremely prepared. Maybe next time we'll get some snowshoes.
Snowshoes.
We talked to some nice people about it today who have these like pro snowshoes with the spikes at the bottom and everything. And looking around, a lot of people have snowshoes. And they have cross-country skis, those really thin kind.
Well,
they look like they're perfect for a place like this.
Yeah.
Shoes, if you can see, my boots are pretty wet. So I would advise someone to bring at least waterproof boots if you're doing this hike in the snow, especially walking through the lake. You can walk in like big puddles of water, basically. So I'm okay now, but I don't know, on the way back, I think my feet are gonna be pretty freezing. This hike does require a lot of energy, so I would recommend bringing a snack and lots of water.
Okay. What are you doing?
Oh, it's snack time.
Are you squatting?
Yeah.
What?
That's the best way to sit. I'm hungry though.
Is it too bright? Are you looking at the sun?
Yeah, it's a little bright. I'm afraid I'm gonna come back with some sunburn for sure.
Yeah, forgot the sunscreen. But we have lots of sunscreen, actually.
But we do have tropical rainbows, which I'm excited about.
That's very exciting.
Yeah, you want one?
Sure.
Okay. They're pretty spectacular.
Let me see.
Look at that.
Oh, where did you get those?
So much chocolate. We got these from Costco. Well, I wish Costco was paying me to promote their items, but they're not. It was still really good though. After our snack, we decided to walk the entire length of the lake and then head back onto the trail. At this point, there were very few hikers around and we noticed some wet spots in the snow, so we proceeded with caution. If we do this again, we will definitely bring some cross-country skis. To get back onto the trail, we had to creep through this really beautiful snow-covered forest. This was probably my favorite part of the hike. It was like a very private, enchanted forest. And soon after, we were right back on the trail, ready to go home. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to my channel so I can bring you more content.